Are you taping?
Oh my god. Oh yeah, my little thing's about to come up to life.
Huh? Yeah, let's make sure the sound's working and stuff. Is there somebody to check that? Hello?
Check. Double, triple.
Because I ain't saying this twice. I sent them a fan letter about 2.5-3 years ago.
That's how you got in?
Yeah. I saw them online and sent them a fan letter and said, I really dig the stuff you're doing. And I had done a few things that they had seen, Gumby and a video game called Clay Fighter and Bump in the Night. And they dug that. So I came over for lunch and one thing led to another. And I've been on the series for about 40 weeks. And we're done now, and I'm getting the bums rushed.
Yeah.
But I've been thrown out of better places. The first story that I feel I brought in that was, you know, the one that I feel kind of proud about was there's that hiker who got caught in the middle of nowhere, and his hand got wedged in, and he was running out of supplies, and had to make that tough decision to actually cut his hand off. So I came in and pitched that story, basically, except it was lumpy rock climbing. And then we kind of batted it around and turned into Out on a Limb, which is still one of my favorite episodes. I came in basically with the idea of Lumpy getting stuck, having to cut off his limb, and it being the wrong one. So that was kind of nice. I walked in with the beginning, middle, and end, and we just had to... What was funny about it, actually, is that it seems really simple. We spent weeks batting it around, just kind of adding all this stuff. Well, we really have to show that it's important that Lumpy has to cut his leg off, because it ended up being a tree pinning his leg, for people who haven't seen the thing. So maybe, you know, maybe there's like, it goes from day to night, and you hear all these growls and stuff, and he's like fighting off things, maybe there's a storm brewing. And we had all this crazy junk going on for weeks. We couldn't solve the thing, and then finally we said, yeah, why don't we just have it that his leg gets pinned and, you know, the axe handle, the axe head flies off the handle and he just has to use the spoon to cut his leg off. What's all this other stuff? So we basically went back to day one and simplified it, turned it into a nice, short, sweet episode that is kind of a fan favorite. Just, I feel if I die before I finish eating, I will have lost. This is why a friend of mine said I should get a t-shirt that says id motivated, which I more or less am. I hope not. You know, it feels that way every week when we have to come up with a new script, actually, and then you come up with one and you go, yeah, I guess there was one more in there. And that will probably continue to happen for quite a while. You know, the difficulty and then coming up with a good one. We talked about doing the last episode totally jumping the shark, having them talk, having them have guns, having them have sex, just going absolutely crazy, you know, bringing in a live action person to like explain things. Yeah, Ken's not into that sort of thing. Don't forget our motto here. Definitely serviceable.